Working mothers have taken their push for better federal government childcare subsidies to our television screens. The group behind the campaign claims the current cost of childcare barely makes working worthwhile. Candice Wyatt reports.
When Fiona Gumbrell had her third child, she had to decide if returning to work was worth it.
At one point, it was going to be me, a stay-at-home mum, but they need the social interactions.
The Australian Women Chamber of Commerce has done the sums and tells us the average working mum battles through an exhausting week and has just $160 to show for it.
There are actually very few benefits for women in this country to go back to work if they have more than two children.
It's launched this media campaign to pressure the federal government into making childcare an election issue.
I think it's also important to say that different women make different decisions once they've had children.
But for some, the choice is made.
The group argues that the lack of childcare places combined with the cost is forcing some working mums to rely on grandparents or hire nannies. Failing that, they say the only other option is for mums to leave the workforce altogether.
Three in four childcare centres don't have vacancies for babies, while two-thirds have no room for toddlers.
Here, my mum looks after the youngest one on Mondays to try and help us reduce the cost of the fees, so we've only got two that have to be paid for.
And that makes Fiona marginally better off than others. Candice Wyatt, 10 News.
And you can tell us what you think about the true cost of returning to work on Twitter at 10 News Melbourne or Facebook / 10 News.